It's time to take a stand. It's time to draw the line. You better bring yours when you come to take mine. So go and round up all them Yankee boys. Get ready for a fight.
General E here with Reaper from SPC. We're going to be talking about a little bit of the gun control, the border crisis, and the whole situation there and what we're going to be doing. Reaper, what's your feeling on the Second Amendment sanctuary status that Texas is going for?
I think we should have never had to be pushing for it to begin with. I mean, it is a constitutional right. Me, myself, I never sold my rights to any government official. Therefore, I don't believe that any of us should have to ask for it back or to fight for it or to pay for it. Same thing with concealed carry permits. I think it's a joke. Shouldn't have to pay for a right that is already constitutionally ours.
Okay, and Texas is moving towards open carry once again. We had a little hiccup the last time. It was a situation where one person pretty much pulled the whole batch. What would your statement be, and what would you say to the people out there that are counting on this to happen and wanting it to happen?
One thing I would say is if you have the bright idea to go and harass any political officials, legislature, senators, congressmen, anything like that, keep your ass at home. We don't need you out there ruining it for, all the people that are, responsible gun owners that want to have a weapon on them for protection. Not only for themselves, but the people that are around them that don't feel comfortable carrying. For children, that's the big thing, The children cannot protect themselves. And any responsible adult that is carrying a firearm, they can protect kids, the elderly that can't fight for themselves. So we don't need people out there harassing politicians, showing up at their homes and threatening them or sending anything like that to, ruin the possibility of it.
Right, just like last time.
Exactly. Just leave that stuff alone, let it take its course, and just don't ruin the show.
What's your thoughts on when Joe Biden explained that there shouldn't be guns in churches and there shouldn't be open carry in churches or anything like that? And then there was a situation up there in White Settlement, Texas, where the gentleman took down, an actual terrorist in the church. What's your opinion on the people that believe that law-abiding citizens should not be able to protect their own in the situation that we're in right now with all the cartel and all the illegal immigration? We have a bunch of, people, and fluctuating into Texas. What's your response to the mentality that we're safer without guns than with them?
My response to that is that's the most idiotic statement that I've ever heard in my entire life. Criminals don't abide by the rules. That is the definition of criminal.
Right.
They will get firearms regardless of any rules, regulations, laws. It doesn't matter. For law-abiding citizens, it's paramount that we do carry. Because criminals are carry. They will continue to carry.
Right.
As far as the church shooting, and as far as, people that say, oh, well, you don't need to carry, or people say, oh, what are you scared of? I'll respond to that with, how many people are you willing to sacrifice? Are you willing to sacrifice your own life because you have no way to protect yourself?
It would be the equivalent of the people blaming school shootings when there's no officer and nobody there that's armed to be able to protect the children and making a no gun zone. What we're saying is, what we're looking at is people that want to diminish the right to protect ourselves, such as the Plano Democrat up in North Texas, basically bringing up the fact that they want to get rid of Castle Doctrine as well. So that's another hot topic on the situation right now, taking away our capability of defending ourselves in our home or our vehicles with the threat of imprisonment if we actually do act and shoot someone. So basically, how do you feel about all of the attacks on our constitutional rights? And are you aware that the new infrastructure plan that's coming out has red flag gun laws and restrictions and gun control in it?
Oh yeah, it's you know, anybody with an ounce of sense in their brain knows that the Democratic Party, the liberals, the communists, the American socialists, you know, they always have a backdoor game. They're going to push their agenda. They're going to do any dirty little deed they can do to get it through. Now, Castle Doctrine on that, I can tell you this much. If they do away with the Castle Doctrine, I will be a criminal after that, because I will not back down and I will not leave if someone breaks into my home.
Amen.
I worked for it. They didn't. I own it. They're not taking it. Absolutely. I have this right here that guarantees that I will keep my property.
And they're coming after that. They're trying real hard.
What I have to say to that is, and every Texan knows this by heart, come and take it.
Damn right. Bring yours if you're going to come take mine.
I will give it to you one hot piece of brass at a time.
Amen, brother. So we've had ERCOT, the freeze, which cost Texans lives because they wanted to tune our generators down for emissions quality and all that kind of stuff. So the Green New Deal people have essentially in Texas already committed murder. They have opened up the immigration. They started up the catch and release programs. They're dropping children over the border, you know, by the thousands every month. You know, how do we fix this border situation? What exactly do we need to do as a border state here in Texas?
Well, one thing we need to do is quit trying to tie the Border Patrol, National Guard, any sort of law enforcement or military type personnel. Quit tying their hands. They are there for a reason, to protect our borders and our safety. These people coming across, from Mexico, from
Central America.
Central America, I mean, all over the world, basically, coming through the southern border. And what I think is, if you are truly running in fear or trying to come to this country to better yourself, do it the proper way. Go through the proper channels. There are people that do it every single day. I have no problem with immigrants coming here as long as they are legal immigrants.
Absolutely.
They come here. They do their part. They pay taxes. They vote. I don't agree with this. Anybody who comes votes. That is not the American way. The United States of America as a whole cannot survive by doing that. That is what will eat this country alive.
Yeah, don't we have our own problems already?
We have so many disabled veterans on the street that are homeless right now that it's sickening. I served this country for 8 years in the United States Marine Corps. I am a disabled veteran. Luckily, I have a family that has a home where I can live. Because if I tried to live on VA disability, I would be homeless.
Right.
There's no way I could afford a home on my own.
Right. But we're going to give $15,000 to
exactly. But yet we are going to give free medical, free housing, free education, just hand out free money to illegal people in this country. But yet our government will not take care of the men and women who fought and died for this country and fought for this country and came home and are not able to work to support themselves anymore, legitimately work. And it's honestly a modern day slap in the face like Vietnam, the men that were coming back from there getting spit on and being called baby killers. This right. is a modern version of that.
Absolutely. Yep.
The biggest slap in the face is giving illegals everything and the people who fought for this
and
country
neglecting
nothing.
The ones. Correct. Okay. All right. So the last thing that I want to ask you is, what would you say to your brothers and sisters in America on the steps and what we need to do and how we need to do it to basically come together with a solution that we can all agree with and that we can all stand up for? How do we do that? And for the ones that are still asleep, what would you say to them?
I would say, grow some thicker skin, grow a backbone. Reach down and make sure you still have a pair. I mean, this is America. Our forefathers would be rolling in their damn graves right now if they were to see.
Absolutely.
And walk around and see what this country has become now and the cowards that Americans have become. How complacent and soft. All this race baiting. Throw that stuff out the window. Race is only an issue because politicians and celebrities keep it an issue.
Right.
We have black people, we have white people, we have Asian people that live in my community right here. We don't have a problem. Why? Because majority of the people around here don't bite on the race bait. We think on our own. We don't let the media tell us what to think, how to live. We live life the way an American should live life. Free, fair, and honest. It's as simple as that.
Absolutely, man.
Quit buying into the stories.
Right. Okay, brother. Well, as far as we're concerned with the border, then we basically need to shut it down. Is the majority opinion, what I'm getting from pretty much everybody.
Yeah.
So I guess we need to go ahead. I mean, how do you feel about the National Guard being called out at 100%?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Minutemen. There's thousands of civilians that would gladly volunteer to secure that border. And we could lock it down in under 12 hours.
Right.
No one in, no one out. If you want to come in, you're going to go through a port of entry the legal way. I kind of throw a funny in here. You know, it's not rocket surgery to shut down the border crisis. And that's what it is. It is a crisis. It's an invasion.
It's an abomination.
Yes.
Created by people that were wanting it to happen.
Everybody wanted to bash Trump about the wall. Well, look what's coming back around. Hypocrisy knows no bounds. Everybody was hating Trump about the wall. Guess what? Your Biden has now admitted he was wrong and is doing the same thing. Is he a racist? Is he a bigot? I think not. Now he has realized what works and what doesn't. Build the wall and stop the invasion.
Amen, brother. Thank you very much.
Not a problem.
Appreciate you, Reaper.
Anytime, brother.
Because you can't stop us out and you can't make us run.
We're some brothers here in Hallettsville, Texas. And we're here to ask them a couple questions about what's going on with the Second Amendment sanctuary status in Texas and what it means to be a Texan and what the Second Amendment means to us. Robbie, how you doing today, brother?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Doing okay, brother. So what do you know about the Second Amendment sanctuary status that's going on in Texas right now?
From what I'm seeing, they're just trying to make it to where no rights can be infringed.
Right.
Second Amendment's a God-given, so there ain't no taking away no guns down here.
Not in Texas.
Not in Texas, baby. Not in Texas.
But they're trying right now.
They're trying. I mean, from what I've seen, they're trying. But if all goes well, ain't nothing going to happen.
So what exactly are they trying to do with this gun control that they're going to be trying to pass? And how are they trying to pass this?
From what I've seen, it's like we talked about earlier, it's the ghost guns. It's anything that deals with what they so-called assault rifles.
Right.
Any parts to it. The ghost guns, like we said, the kit guns. They're trying to do tax stamps, the laws, like the just hella gun control, which there's no need for. I mean, like you said, law-abiding citizens, it's putting a strain on us to be able to get what we need and do what we need to do.
Would these gun control laws affect the people in, say, Chicago or other cities that don't go by the law anyway?
No, I mean, like we said a while ago, on the streets, you can get guns a dime a dozen, legal, no serial numbers, no, it don't matter.
Right.
I mean, they can just probably, we're in Chicago right now, probably hop around a little back alley and just grab two or three of them. I mean, it don't.
Right.
It don't matter to them. I mean, it's, they're lawless, so it's not like they're going to follow the laws they put out anyway.
So the very people they're trying to penalize are the very people that would not be doing any of the things that they're talking about.
So they're doing all this gun control. It's going to stop the law-abiding people to be able to defend themselves. You got people who are going to have the guns that we're not allowed to have, and we'll be shit out of luck.
Okay. So right now, there's been quite a few shootings going on, and they're feeding off that, and they're creating a narrative that it is white supremacists, militia people, all that kind of stuff. What is the truth behind what is going on right now?
I'm not sure. I would say that it's like you said, it's more of a narrative than to create. I guess it was to turn the towards the law-abiding people to make it look like it's them when it's really nothing to do. Like if you really look to see who the people are that are actually doing it, criminals, just hard criminals like that have nowhere need to be around guns or nothing like that, but like we said earlier, they can just get them anytime they want to.
Right.
I mean, it's crazy.
Okay. And all the lies, I don't know if you're familiar with this, but they're talking about how there's not background checks at gun shows and so forth. Have you ever bought a gun at a gun show before?
I haven't, but I've done a lot at gun stores and stuff like that, and I know you got to go through your background checks and it takes hours and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm all for actually seeing if somebody's actually able to purchase a gun, but I've never done anything at a gun show to get.
Yeah, but they do. Yeah, so you're aware that they do background checks already. Okay, there's an infrastructure deal that's coming up pretty soon, and 5% of it basically goes towards the infrastructure. Do you know that the other laws that are being put in through the infrastructure stimulus that they're trying to do?
No, sir. I really haven't checked into it.
Okay, so basically what they have right now is 5% going to actual infrastructure. They've thrown in red flag gun laws in with the infrastructure bill along with gun control. So essentially what they're doing is they are sneaking.
Kind of underlining it in there.
They're sneaking it in, just like the way they did with the COVID stimulus bill.
Kind of like
bill.
The fine lines. You got to read the fine lines so you don't catch it.
Exactly. So what would you say to the Democrats that would like to take our guns away in Texas or anywhere in America for that matter?
Brother, you're not taking this from me. I'll tell you that. Ain't nobody taking our guns.
It never happened.
Not down here.
You better bring yours when you come to take mine,
yes,
huh?
Yes, sir.
Amen, brother. Well, thank you very much,
yes,
my friend.
Chow time.
First thing I remember knowing was a lonesome whistle blowing and the youngest dream of.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Don't make a mess.
On a freight train leaving town.
I won't make a mess at all.
And no one could change my mind but Mama tried. One and only little child from a family meek and mild. My mama seemed to know what lay in store. In spite of all my Sunday learning, towards the bad I kept on turning, till Mama couldn't hold me anymore. I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but Mama tried. Mama tried, Mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, 'cause Mama tried. Thank you.